Greetings, this is another mini video review by the flashlight reviewer Selfbuilt. Today I'm looking at a non-flashlight item, a titanium pen by 4/7. You can see here a case with the new 4/7 logo. You also notice the case is a little dented. I think that's just kind of an artifact of shipping for the review sample. Hopefully they'll ship the final shipping samples in sturdier packaging. The inside, of course, is perfectly unharmed. Inside, what you'll see there is a little titanium pen. The pen uses the standard pressurized Fisher refill. So this is sometimes known as the space pen or the zero gravity pen. You can see it's quite small. I believe the Fisher refill comes in two sizes, one for this sort of mini size pen and one that works in a standard clicky or twisty full length ballpoint type pen. The mini pen, of course, is a convenient size for carrying around. The body, as you can tell here, is a nice sort of finished titanium. It's not overly glossy, sort of more of a matte finish or a brushed finish, kind of like a brushed nickel finish. Fairly sturdy looking clip on top. Some give in it, but I mean quite decent for putting onto a shirt pocket, I think, without ripping it to shreds. You open it up, you can see again it's a fairly stiff, thick looking titanium tube. You can see the ballpoint pen. And of course, as you can see here, the pen writes quite well. That's sort of a medium black ink. The overall size, again, as I said, is quite good. You can see also at the, I don't know if you call that the tail cap or the base, there's a little screw attachment point that you can take off. And inside there, I don't know how well you're going to be able to see that on this kind of camera, there's a little plug that holds the cartridge in place. There's three little holes. You need the right kind of tool or fine tip tweezers to get that out. And on the other side of that plug is the pressurized cartridge. One thing I'll say too about the little plug here that goes on the screw cap, you have a couple of options that you can buy with 4/7. One is the lanyard style, which if we screw this one on instead, you now have a matching titanium lanyard plug. So you could thread a cord through that if you wanted to carry it around your neck. 4/7 also offers another option. You can get the crenellated strike bezel. Although I don't know how many people are going to want to use a pen as a strike weapon, but it's there if you wanted it. You can see sort of the crenellated tips. Personally, I think I'm probably going to stick with the lanyard ring or just the standard flat bezel tip. If you're wondering how this compares to other lights, you can see it's fairly small. I have here a little novelty example of a cheap stainless steel Fisher pen. Like this one's from Universal Studios, Space Pen. Very basic, very similar kind of cartridge. This one doesn't actually use the brand name Fisher cartridge. They just use a cheap knockoff, and they sell these fairly cheaply at novelty items in a variety of places. Air and Space Museums tend to have them as well. If you're wondering how it compares to something like a cross pen, here's a couple of sort of basic model cross pens. There's a thin sort of entry-level model. Here's a slightly older, thicker, more traditional looking type cross pen, but this uses a different kind of cartridge, obviously. But you can see sort of the overall size. Compared to a traditional pen, this is quite the little mini pen. So it's very easy to carry around, very smooth. You can see there's a little 4/7 logo on the top. Otherwise, minimal markings, a very nice kind of overall package for carry. Obviously, there's price is a bit higher than a traditional pen due to the titanium build. You're paying mainly for that, of course. But it seems very solid and well put together, and I like the overall finish and styling of it. Certainly a huge step up from your standard, novelty type space pens. Of course, the whole point of a pressurized cartridge is that it allows you to write upside down, high altitude, places that regular pens wouldn't work. So it's kind of like a nice all-around tool for that sort of purpose. It should last you a long time. I also believe these pressurized pens last a lot longer than a traditional ink cartridge. So you should get a pretty good lifetime out of the pen. Anyway, hope you found that mini non-flashlight review useful. If you want sort of more detailed pictures on the light, including captures of different aspects of it and zoomed in, you can see it under my flashlight review at flashlightreviews.ca or under Candle Power Forums. This will be in the non-flashlight review section, however. If you search for it, you should be able to find it, the 4/7 titanium pen. Anyway, thank you very much. Hope you enjoyed that.